So hello friends, today I am going to discuss about visual cutoff switch, its importance in electrical safety field. So I will start with some statistics related to fatalities just because of electrical energy. So electricity has long been recognized as a serious workplace hazard, exposing employees to electric shock, electrocution, burns, fires, and explosions. In 1999, for example, 278 workers died from electrocution at work, accounting for almost 5% of all on-the-job fatalities that year. Please note down that 5% of all the on-job fatalities that year. This is the statistics of Bureau of Labor. What makes this statistic more tragic is that most of these fatalities could have been easily avoided. So how visual cutoff switch help in prevention of those fatalities? I will discuss today this topic. So visual cutoff switch offered provide for visible break that allows for direct visualization of electrical contact plates that allow for finding if switch disconnector is open or closed. So in nutshell, visual cutoff switch will provide an easy indicator to a user that electrical blades or contacts are disengaged and now energy is isolated, electrical energy is isolated, and one can now, after applying VCS, can work on the circuit. Or you can say equipment. As generated electrical current to photovoltaic installation is dangerous current during working on photovoltaic array. The switch ensures, this visual cutoff switch ensures complete working safety by ensuring grid is in disconnected state. Some of its features include reliable solution support, handle locking in open position that safeguards technicians against reopening of circuit by other person. This is one of the features. Visible break isolation switch lowers electrical risk and protecting lives. This is one of the benefit of VCS. Now, VCS is only mean to isolate the supply and do local isolation. So there is no need to isolate the supply from main control rooms or central control rooms. You can isolate the supply from local, from the location where are you working. You can isolate from there itself with the help of VCS. No need to take isolation from central location. Additional safety feature with VCS is that you can visually check the contact isolation. When you use VCS, you can easily visually you can check the contact isolation, that whether those contacts are terminated or not. VCS can be operated by non-electrical personnel also. There is no need for electrical competency. Anybody can use that, though adequate training must be imparted. This is one. This is also important, that person must be trained in operation of VCS. So always train the person and authorize the person for VCS operation. You can see in this image that contact knife should be in open and off indication of VCS is displayed. So this is a correct way to use the VCS. So some instructions related to operation of VCS. Always first stop the belt, means you can use equipment, stop the equipment using some emergency button or pull cord. Never operate VCS directly. First stop the, apply emergency stop, then switch off the VCS when equipment is in stop condition. Please ensure that all persons working on belt have put their individual lock. The person operating the VCS should be trained to operate the VCS. This is one important point. After working on equipment, when the job is completed and ensure that all material and manpower is removed, then remove all the locks which you have put in the initial stage on the VCS. Now switch on the VCS, reset the emergency button, and now give clearance to control room or central location from where you can restart the equipment or belt. So this is all about VCS. Thanks a lot for hearing with patience. Thank you.